Hi everyone, my name is Mandeep, and in today's video we will continue our next part of machine learning. And in today's video we are going to complete our model building and prediction part, and then checking the accuracy of our model. In previous video we have done feature engineering, and we cleaned our data set completely. Only thing that I missed in previous video, which I will cover in this video and is part of feature engineering as well. So that is actually treating the outliers. So that part somehow I missed it, but I will cover that part into this video. And again, this video is in continuation with the machine learning playlist. So I have been using the same data set and same notebook from last three videos. So if you want to get the right context, you can please check my previous videos as well. So let's get started with today's video. For treating the outliers, that part I missed in my previous video. So in today's video, let's cover that part. So basically, I checked that in our FAIR column, we have some outliers, and how we can treat those outliers. Again, outliers can significantly impact your prediction results. So it is always recommended that we should treat the outliers before training our model. During our feature engineering part. So let us continue with it. So basically here you can see that I have from SciPy library, I am using stats class, and there is a method in it which basically gives you the z-score of any column. And in my previous video, I have shown it to shown that how that score actually work. So it is the same concept. It's just handy because it has been already written. So I'm using this here. So how it works in this stats.zscore, stats is my class and zscore is method. And inside my method, I'll pass the data frame array or list, you can say, or data frame column. So here I'm passing my FAIR. So it will give me a list, and then I am assigning or an array, and then I am assigning it into a new column that I am appending with my data frame one. So basically, after this, you will be able to see that. So our Z score values are -3 and +3 are the boundary values. Anything beyond these are outlier for us. So I'm checking here that in my data frame, if my data frame dot FAIR Z score, which is a newly added column, which basically contains the Z score of FAIR column with respect to each entry. And I'm checking that if any value in that column below than -3 and above than 3, then please show me those rows. So I'm just checking those rows. So you can check that these are the rows where my Z score is like 4.35 for this FAIR, and similar 3.76 something, and then for this FAIR. So you can see there are a good number of rows are available for FAIR column. And doing this for FAIR column, what we can do using now I want to replace these outliers. So these FAIR values are outliers for me, 151, 134, 164. So I need to treat these values. So I need to replace these values some another value. And in this video, I'm going to use median, because out of mean, median and mode, median is the less impacted by outliers, whereas mean is significantly impacted by outliers. So we cannot replace our fair values with the mean of this column. So basically I will be finding the median of this column fair and will be replacing each value where my z score is above than 3 or less than minus 3. So that's what I am doing. So what I am doing in my np.fair is a method in NumPy library, where basically you give some certain condition and that particular condition is applied onto that NumPy array, and then it returns you a new NumPy array. So basically what I am doing here for data frame 1, where my fair.z score, this is my newly added column, is greater than 3, then replace it with the median, otherwise keep the same fair. So this will be my new fair, and you can check that and then I am again checking the same the values where my z score was less than minus 3 or z score was greater than 3. So basically you can check the difference between. So let's say for this first row, where this is 141 row, fair was 151, and after replacing it with it, after treating it with median, then you can see that my fair get updated 14.45. so basically for all these rows my fair got updated. So basically what I have done for the outlier value in my fair column, I have replaced those outlier value with the median of this fair column. And the same thing I have done for this age column as well, on the same lines, exactly same. So first I am trying to find where my z score, what is my z score for age column, and then I am checking what are the values where my z score for age column is less than minus 3 or greater than 3. Then I will be finding those rows, and in those rows I will be updating those value of age column with the median of age. So I'm doing where my age score is greater than 3, and then replace it with the median of age, otherwise keep the same age. So that's what I'm doing here. After this, so this part is kind of left from our previous video, and this dividing the data into independent and dependent features, and that part was already covered in previous video. So we will be continuing with this this video now onwards. So basically so far we have cleaned our data set, and after cleaning our data set, what we can do, we can basically divide our data set into two subsets. One subset will be of training, one subset will be for testing. Generally, a general rule that is being followed by machine learning engineers, they generally keep the test size less and the training size a bigger size, so that your model gets trained effectively, so that it can predict the good results. So there is a library, sklearn library, in that we have a class train test split, and inside train test split we pass the x, the independent features, the target feature. Random state is an attribute, you can pass any value for it, 1, 2, 300, whatever. And stratify can be passed as y or n. That part I will cover in later videos, what does this actually means. Test size is the basically how much is the test size that we want to keep for our test data. So generally, let's say if you have 100 records, then 0.35 means then 35% of the data will be kept for test subset, and 65% will be kept for training subset. So here I'm splitting my data set. And after splitting, since this in this particular problem, we are kind of predicting that particular passenger was survived or not. So it's a kind of classification problem. We basically classifying our results into two category. For those this sort of problem, we generally use a logistic regression. Logistic regression is in detail I will cover in my coming videos. Till then, you can understand in this way that there is a class and logistic regression, and we can create an object of it and assign it, consider it as a model, and then we can train that model. So from sklearn.model, I'm importing my logistic regression class, and then I'm creating an object of it, and I'm assigning it into a variable named as model. After I have created a blank model of logistic regression type, and then I want to train it. So to train it, there is a method in this logistic regression class, fit method, whereas in you pass the train, xtrain and ytrain. Xtrain is basically your training subset of independent feature, and xtest is your test subset of independent feature. Ytrain is your set of training dependent or target variable, and ytest is your dependent variable, or the for which we want to do the prediction. Y value is that from test subset. So we pass the X train and Y train into our while training our model using fit method. Now our model has been kind of trained over this or this data set. Now model has learned how data is internally kind of related with each other. A training part is done, and now it is the time to predict. Like you pass some new value other than the values on which the model has been trained. So that's the only reason we generally split our actual data set into two parts, so that we can evaluate our model on the data which it has never seen before. So I am passing here x test, as I told you, is the set of independent feature from test subset. So we pass that into predict method is there for which, and for that whatever the values it has returned, I have kind of assigned into y pred variable. And now checking the accuracy score. To check the accuracy score, again there is a class accuracy score which is in sklearn.matrices, and you can pass the y test and your y predicted. So basically, it will give you a number, and the number will be of 0. Now here it is showing that 0.85. That means that 85% of the values has been correctly identified by this model. And one more thing, this is an additional thing. So this thing I have done prediction on the training data set just to check that our model is not overfitting. Now what is overfitting, that part I also will cover in our coming videos. Overfitting as of now you can understand in this way, that overfitting is something when your model performs really good while training, but the same model performs really poor on the test data set. So just to check how my model is performing on my training data set and how my model is performing on my test data set. So that's the reason I just checked it, and I can see that it is the same, 85% and 85%. So in this video, that's all for now. And in our coming video, we will be covering more topics on machine learning. And thanks for watching. And the last thing every YouTuber say, I also do. If you like my videos, my content, then please like my channel, subscribe it, and share it with your friends. And if you want something specific on machine learning, then you can leave the comment, and I will be working on that part as well. So thanks for watching. Till then, bye bye, take care.